Humans created farming around 12,000 years ago, but there was another species that independently created farming way before we did. 55 million years before, in fact. It wasn't the Neanderthal or any ape. It was actually the lowly ant, an insect. Specifically these guys. You've all probably seen a clip like this on a nature documentary setting the scene of a wild rainforest. But in the rainforest, it's not actually obvious what these ants are doing. Let me put it this way. If you put leafcutter ants into an ant farm and then you watched them build a colony, you'd have an ant farm farm. They don't farm corn or cows, but they farm fungus. We'll come back to that in a second. Leafcutter ants, like the famous Attacephalotes, literally cut leaves and then carry them on their backs to their colony. But have you ever thought about what they do when they get there? Because the ants don't eat the leaves they carry, which is what I thought they did. No, they use them to grow crops. They use them for agriculture. Agriculture, by definition, is the science or practice of farming, including the cultivation of the soil for the growing of crops. Also, the rearing of animals to provide food, wool, and other products. Ants are doing this. They dig growing chambers in their colonies, down in deep tunnels to control their temperatures. They bring dew and water from the surface to the chambers to control humidity of their crops. And this is where the leaves come in. The atta ants drink the sap, clean the leaves, crush them up, and then compost them with their own fecal liquid. Delicious. And the fungus, a basidiomycete type, grows on this soil that they create. Then they harvest bits of the fungus and use it to feed their colony, just like human farmers. We are still new to farming. Wheat is one of the oldest farmed grains, but it wasn't until Norman Borlaug bred two special wheats together that humans could finally use it to feed millions upon millions of people. He won the Nobel Peace Prize for this in 1970. But that is noob science in comparison to ants who have been using agriculture to feed millions of ants for millions of years. Atta ants have evolved over millions of years alongside their crops, weeding, watering, and preening. One species of ant has even cultivated a fungal line that produces high yields to feed even more ants. No peace prize for them, though. The coolest part about this is some of the 250 species of ant that have evolved agriculture have also cultivated their crops so much that without the ants, it would die. The fungus only exists to feed the ants. Another cool thing, ants aren't the only farming species out there. Termites are also fungal farmers, and here you thought they were just eating your house. Nope, they feed some of those bits to their fungal friends. Damselfish are the only known fish to be agriculturalists, farming algae for their food. There are even species of beetle and snail with this practice, but come on, why should we care about this? Because we've only been farming for 12,000 years, and scientists are not sure farming is a sustainable practice. We have to feed billions of people, meaning we need to use monocultures. One super plant that can feed lots of people, that's what the ants do, just like the Borlaug wheat. But growing crops this way can deplete the soil, like with corn, or subject large crops to disease, like with bananas. The atta ants and other fungal farmers have been cultivating these monocultures for millions of years. If we can learn how they manage to avoid devastation by disease, or how they protect their crops from parasites, maybe we could support another few billion of our own human colony. Aren't ants awesome? You want to learn more about them? We talked to a bug scientist who calls himself the Ant Man. You can check it out right here. What do y'all think of these mini farmers? Let us know down in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe and come back for more videos.